I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Well, darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes you're holding mine. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it. Darling, you look perfect tonight.
Well, I found a man stronger than anyone I know. Shares my dreams. I hope that someday we'll share our home. I found love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. We are still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright this time. Darling, just hold my hand. Be your girl, you'll be my man. And I see my future in your eyes. Well, baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, while listening to our favorite song.
When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect.
On behalf of this wonderful couple, I want to say thank you for being here. I know that you spent money, you invested time, energy to be here, and it's truly, truly appreciated on behalf of this wonderful couple. You are happy that they are here, aren't you? Yes? Yeah? Oh, good, yeah. Good. So, yeah. Well, I'm happy you're here, otherwise it would be pretty boring without you guys. Okay. Leigh, I want you to take a deep breath, relax, enjoy what's about to take place. Chris, breathe as well. And just enjoy. This is so important that you just relax. Lot, I'm going to ask you a very important question. Who gives this bride to be married today?
I, Lot and Catherine. would like to give this daughter of ours to a Mr. Chris Morris Land.
Fantastic.
No loyalty and no any
conditions. Fantastic. And you've explained there's a no return clause? That's just the deal. I'm going to ask you to lift the veil and you can give your daughter a wonderful kiss and then you can shake hands with Chris maybe. Thank you very much. You can have a seat. Thank you. Guys, you can just move a little bit closer together if you would like to. I'm going to need your help for a moment, everybody. I want you just to sort of agree with me if you agree with me, and I'm sure you're going to, but I think that Leigh looks absolutely gorgeous. Does she look gorgeous?
Yes, definitely.
Chris, not bad, eh? Not bad.
Pretty good. I feel underdressed.
You feel underdressed?
Per usual.
Well, I was going to ask what people think of you, but maybe I shouldn't if you feel that way. But does Chris look good?
Yes, I think so.
Chris, you look stunning.
Thank you.
The few times I've seen you before, you look absolutely stunning. So that's cool. Guys, I do want you just to be present in this moment, and I want you just to not focus on any of the worries that you might have. I mean, look at this gorgeous, gorgeous place that you've got to do this wedding. You've got magnificent people, so we just want to make sure that you are just ready to really enjoy what's about to take place. So I'm going to ask that we just start off just by doing a very quick opening prayer. So if we could just close our eyes for a moment. Our God and loving Heavenly Father, what a privilege you've given us to come together in the beauty of this place on this wonderful day, that we can come together to witness as Chris and Leigh make a promise to each other as they step off on this journey as husband and wife. Father, we ask that you'll bless them in a very special way. Give them the ability to work well together. May they communicate well together. And we ask that you'll bless them with a long and a happy marriage. And every single one of us that's here, Father, we ask that we'll take beautiful, wonderful memories home with us and be able to talk about this day for years to come. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Leigh, you decided you were going to go off to LA. You were going to a wedding, if I remember correctly.
No, just a holiday.
Just a holiday. Okay.
Holiday, yes.
Sorry. And you got to LA. When you got on the plane,
yes.
Was it your intention to go find a husband?
No.
Sure?
No.
Are you sure?
Huh? No.
Just trying to hang out.
Just trying to hang out. You see how dangerous aeroplanes can be?
Yes.
You know? This is what it leads to. But when you went to LA, without any inkling that this was going to change your life, that this trip, this moment was going to change your life. And Chris, do you remember when you met Leigh for the first time?
Yeah, definitely. I saw her standing in front of the bar we were going to meet at. She looked really beautiful, and I was like, oh shit, I gotta find a parking spot as quickly as possible.
Fine.
It's LA, so it took like 10 minutes, and I was worried she'd be mad. You know.
Were you mad?
No, I wasn't impressed, but I wasn't mad.
You weren't impressed.
We did an SA fist bump, yes. And all was...
Oh, wait, I was mad at the fist pump, then I was like, no, in SA we do it like this. This is a proper fist bump.
There we go. But you know what? What's so fantastic is that you went with no intention, and you certainly did. You have any inkling at that stage? You were there in LA for what reason? You were working there?
Yeah.
I can't remember.
Well, living, not working much.
Okay, but you were there, and you certainly didn't go with an intention of finding a wife in LA.
No.
Probably not.
No, I just thought Leigh was cute.
Brilliant. And this was way back in 2018.
Yes.
Now, guys, I want you just to think back to that very moment where you saw each other for the first time. That first time you connected. That was the start of your beautiful, wonderful love story. The once upon a time, if that was to be written on your story at the beginning of your story, that would be the moment that it was done. Once upon a time, there was a young man called Chris, okay, who was parking his car and, okay, let's leave that issue out. Leigh, you are the young lady in this, the princess of this story. And guys, you met that moment. And you know what's happened to you since that moment, all the things that you've been through, these experiences that make up this wonderful thing called your story. And these wonderful people that are here, they know parts of your story because they've added color and vibrance and, you know, happiness and joy to your story. But nobody here knows your story except the two of you. It's your story. Okay, so I want you to take ownership of your story. Don't allow yourself to say, well, the story is something that happened in the past. We're only going to focus on the future. Have you been the happiest that you've ever been since you've been with Chris?
Yes.
Chris?
Definitely.
You as well? You've been the happiest that you've ever been since you've...
Yes.
Good answer. It's a good answer. Good answer. But the reality is, I'm sure that you've had the greatest of times since you've met. But I'm sure that you've also been through some difficult patches, sometimes where things were more of a struggle than other times. But every experience, whether it be good or difficult, has led you to this moment right now where you're about to say I do to each other. And you're about to take each other as husband and wife. And that's incredibly important because that's your story. Now, I made the assumption that this is a love story. Is it a love story? So let me ask, do you love Lee?
I do.
How much?
A lot. Oh.
What did he say?
My love in Setswana.
Oh, very nice. Okay, that's beautiful. And look, I'm going to start a little bit lower, Lee. I'm going to work my way up. Do you like
him?
Him?
I like him?
Yeah.
Definitely.
A little bit more?
Yeah. Yeah. I like him.
A lot?
But I love him more than I like him.
Ah. So important.
A lot more.
You did it.
You know what's so amazing is the fact that you guys do have something amazing. It's called your love. It's your love. It's your love. No one else knows what that love is. It's a unique love that the two of you share that no one else will ever understand. You know, from the outside looking in, people will see that you love each other. I could ask anybody here, do you love each other? They'll say, absolutely, 100%. I'll say, how do you know? They'll say, well, we can see how they interact with each other, how they deal with each other, the things that they've been through, the experiences that we've seen. That's the way that you demonstrate your love to other people. But it's not about doing that. It's not about saying, I'm going to show other people how I feel about this person. It's how you show each other as well, the interactions that you have, the way you deal with each other. So guys, the fact that you love each other, remember how important it is that you understand that no one knows what that feeling is. Look at each other. I know you're looking at each other, but look at each other and just know, Chris, you have a specific feeling of love inside of you. What you feel for Lee, she has no idea what that feeling is because she can't feel what's inside of you, and vice versa. So guys, you can't wait for somebody to come along later on in your marriage. A year, 20 years from now, to remind you of what that love is. No one can do it because they don't know. In fact, you can't even ask each other to be responsible to make sure that that person is the person that's going to explain to me what that love is, because you don't know what each other feel. So take that responsibility on yourself and say, I am responsible for the love that I have for the person standing right in front of me right now. And I'm going to make sure that I have that feeling constantly in my heart for the rest of my life. Do you love each other more today than the first time that you met each other?
Yeah.
Absolutely. I mean,
I thought I'd never see him again, so yeah.
Yeah, you know, and what's happened is over the period of time that you've been together, you've listened to each other, you've learned things about each other, you've given yourself the opportunity to know each other better and better and better, and that feeling of love has grown and grown and grown. But guys, today is not the end of that process. Don't think for a moment that because you are now legally married today, that you don't have to listen to each other or you don't have to learn new things. There's so much more to learn and to discover. So just be open to that, okay? So look after your love. Who said I love you first in your relationship? Did he? Was it 20 minutes after he parked? Or how long after he parked?
Six months
after he parked.
Yeah.
Once upon a time in Durban.
Yes, in Durban.
In Durban.
And that's it.
Of all places.
In Durban, yes.
In Durban.
Yes.
Yo, okay.
Yes. I asked him in the morning if it's, are you real? Like.
When you said those words for the first time, Chris, you said it because you felt it. You meant it.
Yes.
you would have heard it, and you would have heard it with emotion. You might have been a bit shocked, and you might have thought, is he actually me being serious? But the reality is, he said it, you would have reacted in a way. And I want you to remember, in your marriage, always say I love you with the same meaning that you said it the very first time. Don't hear those words without emotion. Don't hear those words and just simply say I love you too, without thinking about what those words mean. So guys, look after this thing called love, your love, special love. I want to ask, are you friends? Would you say that you're friends?
Yes.
Best friends?
Yeah.
Brian's my, but he's my friend.
Brian, you're what?
I can't say it in front of my parents. Sorry. And we have a joke.
Okay.
Inside joke.
Okay.
Essay expression. Well,
yeah.
Whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. We won't go there. Okay. But are you best friends?
I guess so.
I'm so sorry that I'm forcing you to accept the fact that you might be friends. No, but you know what, guys? The truth is, you would not be doing what you're about to do if you didn't love each other. That's fact. But I don't think there's many people that get together on the day of their marriage, stand in front of friends and family to make a commitment to each other, and they don't actually enjoy and like each other. So if you like each other, if you are friends, if you share the attributes that friends share, for instance, laughter, crying together, sharing your dreams, having common goals, having this understanding where you can have fun together, even the ability that you might have to fight with each other and forgive, that's what's important about a friendship. And guys, you're going to get a great brand new title today, husband and wife. And that title is going to come with responsibilities, roles, and duties. And I know, in my heart of hearts, I know that you would like to take on that role and be the best that you can be at it. And you want to be the best that you can be for each other, the best wife and the best husband. And guys, you can achieve that if you just focus on making sure that you don't leave your friendship behind. Go through your lives and say, look, if we can be best friends to each other, who happen to be married, that's going to be absolutely awesome. You don't want to be married to each other, but you don't actually like each other. Okay, that's important. So guys, laugh together, cry together, share your dreams, have fun together, and enjoy your friendship. Don't allow that friendship to disappear. Now today, you're standing here in front of these wonderful people, and you're about to make a promise to each other. And that's it's a very important moment within your story. But guys, you would obviously understand that your story does not end today, and it certainly doesn't start today. Maybe the beginning of a brand new chapter, but this is the start of this chapter, this journey that you're going to be on. I want you to focus on saying, you know what, we control, the two of you, you control what your story is going to be. Make it what you want it to be. Think about a blank sheet of paper. One day, God's going to give you this blank sheet of paper, and on that day you're going to write that part of your story, and it's going to be based on your interactions with each other, the way you laugh together, all those things that you do, the good, the difficult, all of that is going to be written down page by page, day by day. But you know what, every day you can reflect on a page and you can say, was that a good page in our book? And if it was, you can say fist bump time, okay, or other things, you know, whatever. But if it wasn't the best of days, you can say, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Tomorrow is another day. I'm going to get a blank sheet of paper tomorrow so I can make right what went wrong today. So I want to just say, are you guys ready to do this?
Yeah.
On behalf of these wonderful people, and I'm sure there must be loads of other people all over the world that would love to have been here that couldn't be here, but I want to say, on behalf of everybody, I want to wish you all the romance, all the excitement of a beautiful and wonderful life together. Every dream, Chris, Leigh, that you have for each other and you have for yourselves, we hope, we pray it'll come true for you, not once, but over and over again. Enjoy the moment now, this great, incredible moment where you become husband and wife. It is the special moment, but it's not the greatest of all moments. There's so many great moments that are still coming, so look out for those as well. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, you're ready?
Yes.
Great. Somebody want to come take the bouquet, please? I appreciate that. Thank you.
Thanks,
Neil. Thank you. Right. I'm going to ask you guys just to step closer to each other. Hold right hands, please. Don't kiss. Right hands. Right hands.
Right hands.
Right hands. No, right hands.
Right hands. Oh.
I'm so glad this is water. It's a very common thing, so don't worry about it. All right, I'm going to ask you a declaration. Chris, you're going to acknowledge by saying I do, nice and loud. Everybody needs to hear, okay? Do you, Chris, declare that as far as you know, there is no lawful impediment to your proposed marriage to Leigh here present?
I do.
Fantastic. Leigh, do you declare that as far as you know, there is no lawful impediment to your proposed marriage to Chris here present?
I do.
Fantastic. Now, I know that some of you, how many are from America? Okay, so you'll be used to the question being asked about the objections. So I'm not going to ask that question. We don't do that here. So I'm going to ask you a very positive question, and I'd love you to verbalize your support of this awesome couple. So a simple question, are you here to support Chris and Leigh in their marriage?
Yes.
Doesn't sound like it. Are you?
Yes.
Phew. Chris, you have your own vows that you have put together. I'm going to ask you in your own time, you can take your vows out and you can hold right hands and you can then tell Leigh your vows, please.
Okay.
The black book.
I have bad handwriting. Hopefully, I can read my own handwriting. Leigh Jane, if that really is your name, I feel that we can survive 19 months of long-distance relationship in racist Korea, cold Seattle. We can survive literally anything. If we can survive planning a wedding, and then planning another wedding, and then probably planning a couple more after that in America, we can survive anything. Therefore, I plan to love you in all places. Even the Santon City Mall, Natasha's, under the American or African sky, when making me laugh or grinding my tits.
You said it in front of my parents!
As a partner and equal, I pledge to love you from here to Seattle, Rerato Laka. BJ.
I know you want to kiss, but you can't.
Yeah.
Your book's right there.
Dumela Re. I want to start off by telling the story of the day we met. I remember it so clearly on that day I walked from Santa Monica Beach to Venice. And in the afternoon I sat on a bench speaking to the universe, looking out to the sea. I was tired from the day, definitely reluctant to meet up with a stranger in a strange city. I can certainly, absolutely, definitely say I'm so glad I took the risk, because it's been a whirlwind, a crazy adventure, and the most rewarding decision I've ever made. It led me up to the love of my life. The first pet name I gave you was OCCML, meaning King Christopher Morrisland. And for that, I love you. I really do. And I thank you for the kindness of fighting for this, because you're the most amazing man.
Yeah, it's good. Has anybody got the rings for us, please? Guys, if you could just take each other's ring and just hold it on the palm of your right hand for a moment, please. There we go. Yeah, so you put it on the palm of your right hand. There we go. Okay, so what I would like to do is I would like you just to look at the ring for a moment, and I want you to see that the ring is a very special gift that you give each other on the day that you get married. It is a sign to the world of this commitment that you made to each other today, that you're making to each other. It's a sign of that continued commitment. So I want you to remember that even though the ring might have cost a few rand or a few dollars or whatever, some money to buy it, that the value of that ring is not determined by what that value of that money that you spent. What is the value of that ring are four things that I want you to continually remember throughout your marriage. Number one, your unique and amazing love that you share, that only you understand. Two, this incredible friendship you enjoy. This amazing story that you're creating together, that's the third thing. And the fourth thing are those words that you've said to each other now as a promise. We've all heard them, so now you have to live up to those promises. So I'm going to ask you just to close your hand, make a fist, give it a squeeze, wish it well, and then I'm going to ask Chris, I'm going to ask you a simple question, and you're going to just place the ring onto Leigh's finger. Chris, do you give this ring as a token of your love and a sign of your promise to Leigh?
I do.
Okay, give it to her.
Here you go.
Okay. You have to remove it.
Yeah, go.
Oh, I see.
Ready?
Let's do it.
Ready? The other way, turn it.
I was going to rotate it on the finger.
Oh, okay. There we go. Wow.
Gosh.
Amazing. You did it. Ooh,
shiny.
Okay. Well, but that's still my ring. You have to put it back.
Oh, on top of it?
Yeah, wait.
Don't worry. Just do it. It's fine. You can spend a lot of time sorting it out later with him.
Yeah.
All right, Leigh, I'm going to ask you a simple question. Leigh, do you give this ring as a token of your love and a sign of your promise to Chris?
Yes, I do. Ready?
Other hand.
Other hand, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Thank
you, bye-bye. Wow, looks good.
Mmm.
Sound surprised.
Chris is going to feel like this for a while, but it's okay.
It's going to feel like that.
In the presence of God and before these witnesses, Chris, Leigh, you've given your consent and you've made your vows to each other. You've declared your marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of a ring. I therefore have the privilege now to declare and to pronounce you as husband and wife, and you are to be husband and wife together from this day forward. That which has been joined together, let no one ever divide. Chris, COVID is a terrible thing, and according to South African law, you're not allowed to kiss yet because of COVID. No, I'm joking, of course. Guys, I want to share this moment with everybody. I'm going to count to three, and we're all going to shout out, Chris, you may kiss your beautiful wife. One, two, three. Chris, you may kiss your beautiful wife. You guys had what, how long were you guys in different places? 19 months. 18 months. 19 months.
God, that's
That's pretty hectic. But I can fully understand why your kissing is so bad, because you haven't had a lot of time to practice. So, you know, for the purposes of the cameras and for your folks and your wife that wants a decent kiss, go for it, my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Morris Lent. Make some noise!
Suited for each other, yeah. Don't try to move me from my lover, yeah. Suited for each other, suited for each other. Tailor made, I'm glued up on my lover. Another, yeah. When we talked on the phone and you said that you love me, did you say that this for sure? Yeah.
All right. I'm Mark.
Mike's mic'd up.
I'm mic'd up. I don't know if that makes me any louder or not.
All right. Given that this is a very gregarious man who likes to talk a lot, let's give him his full attention.
Okay, go for it.
All right.
Stand up.
Stand up.
So, the first thing that I would say is that as a parent, when you have a child, you really don't know what that really means until they grow and grow, and until they eventually become an adult, and you know, they're still your kid.
What adults?
For better or worse.
Not an adult.
Well, for different. Yeah, they're. I would say that as we've grown up with Chris as our son, that he has taken us on paths that we would never have imagined. And sometimes that happens when you have a child. Like when we were young, or when he was young, and I guess I was younger too, we spent a lot of time doing what I considered fun things, and I think he did too, in junior high, chasing math competitions. And he was very good. He had a very strong team, and that was very fun to be a part of as a parent. And later on, when he was in high school, he let me tag along when he did things like the chess team that he had. And the funny thing was that his school had so many chess players that it had two chess teams, and it ended up having two chess teams that made it to our state finals. And Chris was on the second chess team. He was the captain of it, actually. And they did so well that, what did you guys finish, like, in fifth?
It was a good showing.
It was good for a second team from his own school in the state. So, I'm just saying, I never would have imagined that as a parent, you know? It's just sort of an unusual thing. And another unusual thing is that he went to school on the East Coast of the United States, I think partly for the adventure and for the challenge of doing that. I'll brag a little bit. After school was done, he started his own business. That's a hard road to hoe. If anybody has done that, they have my full respect. All the things that are needed to create a successful business, they're hard to get the right combination of. And so now, this path that's I've never would have predicted and has gone in many different directions has taken us as a family to South Africa, where we have had the honor and privilege and the delight of meeting and taking on a new family member as a daughter and daughter-in-law. And taking on new family members as in-laws.
I like the in-loves.
And in-loves, which is a lovely local tradition. And meeting close friends who, by the way, we are big fans of what we call posses. And both of our sons have good sets of friends. Our younger son, James, has a very good set of friends that he made in college too. And we know that he will keep them as good friends through the rest of his life, and they'll be there for each other. So as representatives of Lee's posse, Crystal and Nao, and T, your sister, and I think you're also a posse member. You know, the role that you'll play in each other's lives, it means an awful lot. And we see it, and we see it in our son's lives with his best man joining us as well. So, you know, it's really cool to see you being there for each other. So, a very interesting path for us as parents that we never would have imagined in our lives. I did imagine wiping C out in fantasy football this week.
Seems like you thought it into existence.
And of course, we're here to wish our new newlywed couple to a happy and long and fun and caring relationship. And we hope also the opportunity for all of us to get to know each and every one of us better as an extended family and friends as well. So here's to Chris and Leigh, and to everybody at this table. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Astrovia.
Astrovia.
Kanpai.
Kanpai.
All right. As I'm standing here, I would like, actually, first and foremost, to thank all the people that are around the table here, whereby we're finalizing the whole matter today between Leigh and Chris. Moreover, I would like to say thanks to the crew and the partners and the friends as well, to Chris that came along and make this also a success. You know, overall, I'll say Leigh is a second daughter, and like she grew up, she liked school. And liking her school was, I was always to be, I don't know. No, I was a victim, because now every time she comes back late from school, then I must come from work and then wait for her at school till late and bring her home, and tomorrow morning I must go back to work. So in that way, I said, now she grew up as a good child, and I think she maintains that mentality and she doesn't deviate from that. And to Mr. Christopher Morris Leigh, Morrisland actually, sorry, and to Leigh as well, I would say, please, in this reunion of yours, or maybe in this union of yours, say then, put God first.
Amen.
And the rest must follow. Eh? And also, love is got just only four letters. If you can define them well, you'll find the answer out of that. And I wouldn't be that long anyway, but I say, God must give you or grant you wealth, must grant you its peace, and as I say, everything will be history. To the toast, on the two of you up. Okay.
Thank you,
there you go, there we go, there we go. There we go. There we go, there we go.
All right.
Zach,
make us peace.
Zach Murray would like to see
it.
Yeah, I can do that. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today. I didn't have any idea I was going to do this speech until about 15 seconds ago, so I'm feeling very prepared. This is much more time than I usually prepare for most of my life decisions. You know, CML and I have been friends for 10 years.
9 years.
Nine, I'll round up. He's good at math. I met him when I moved out to Seattle, and I did so leaving everything I knew behind. My family, my friends, everything that I loved was on the other side of the country.
And so I came out with nothing, and I, you know, played a silly card game here and there and decided that I was going to go out and just find people who did it too. And that's how I met Chris, playing at some pretty dingy places on Aurora Avenue in Seattle. And just started traveling together, and it was crazy. You could tell because he's laughing so hard how crazy it was. Like, I don't want to undersell that point.
What was the most deranged thing that you did?
That I did? I think we should be talking about you, my friend.
Fair enough. What's the most deranged thing that I did?
Well, you know, if you're playing this game with CML, the problem is he can't shuffle his cards right.
Oh my gosh.
No, I kid. I have to give it to CML and to, you know, most of the people in his circle of friends. He has a personality that, you know, kind of, you don't understand it until you get close to him. And it, like I said, it's hard to explain, but when I needed someone to, like, help me find my tribe, he was there. He helped me find my friends in Seattle. He helped be there for me when I needed someone to just be with, you know? And it didn't end there. Of course, later I met Leigh in Seattle. We went out for a couple of drinks, and at the time I was like, CML has a girlfriend? And I thought that was really weird. And actually, I haven't changed my opinion on that. That was really weird. We went and played pinball, and like we did a bunch of other stuff and had some beers, and it was great. But at that time, I had no idea that we were going to go on this crazy, amazing adventure together and be here today. And I am so, so thankful that he was there and that we are all here together today to be together and to celebrate such an amazing person, an amazing couple, an amazing group of friends, and an amazing family. So. That is what I have to say about CML and all of us. Thank you. And let's all raise our glasses to our newfound friends and family. Here. Yay.
Another one. Another one.
The last time it was just tears.
Yeah, I think this one might be a bit better because the last time it was just all tears. But I've sort of composed myself because I've just realized how beautiful everything is and just like really in the moment. So yeah, I've known Lee for 10, 11 years now? 12? I don't know. You do the math. But we've known each other for a while. And you know, it's crazy because the first time we actually met, we were getting ready to fight. Crazy. I swear to you, like we'd had a bit of an argument in the class, and her friends were waiting for me at the door. And you know, I don't know what happened along the day, like we just sort of hit it off, and then we've just become friends ever since. And we haven't had a lot of friends, like we don't have like a very big squad, so it's always been me and her. And I think at even like the first wedding, I just realized, oh my God, like my other half is gone. Literally, even if I'd go to parties by myself, it'd be like, but where's Lee though? It was so weird because it's always been like Neo and Lee, and now it's just Neo, no Lee. But like I couldn't be happier because she's in the best hands. Chris is lovely. And when I was listening to him earlier on saying that the first time he told her he loved her was in Durban. I was so excited because the first time, like in Durban is my hometown, and that was the first time they'd come to South Africa, and they came to my home, they met everyone, and everyone was talking about like how lovely they were as a couple. And like if you've ever been around them, you know like how obsessed they are with each other, and it's just like, it's so beautiful to watch. It's just like I love them and I love their love, and I couldn't be happier. If I had any reservations before, like I don't think I will I mean, I wouldn't be standing here out of politeness, but like, but like, yeah, but like, I don't think like I would be speaking from the heart the way I am. And like, I have no reservations at all. I know for a fact that my best friend is in the best of hands, and she's met someone who absolutely loves her. And that's the most important thing. I think, like, even as a family, when you hear that your friend, your sister, your daughter is going so many miles away, you always wonder, like, is she going to be okay? And I think we all know for a fact that she is okay, she's safe, she's secure, she's loved by Chris. And that's the most important part. And I couldn't be happier. I think that's why we're just all at peace. We just had the most beautiful day. And I love you. I love you both. And congratulations. Yay! To Chris and Lee.
Khaitseraka ba go tsemotla skaka e ka le rato ga bana le ntotedi e ba khona go tsanwa ga khona o le tselong re ba tsa uta ka
tsara
o tabatola ke la e ka le bo ga ka bana ba ka ba ntsa ja ka mogolo wa bone ka ba nyatsi ya ka dilo go bone all the time ka bana le spane ba ditsa to ga ke malma bone ke ka mo maroga mama bone e ba ntompa e ke ka ke le ka le bo ga ka le bo ga ka le bo ga Chris arbone ile Meroko Shapo for the Walinyalo Wai. We thank you, little parents, for Radum Ralevoca on that man. You are going to go in the end there, not the political Christian Tedinyane in school, eh? That apartheid thing, eh? The political Christian, that's right.
I could not possibly follow that in any meaningful or adequate way. And I, like Zach before, did not actually expect to give a speech, though I am honored to be asked. But, you know, I've known CML, as I will always call him, for a very long time, second only to his parents at this event, I believe, by a wide margin. And I will just keep it simple and just say that I think this is genuinely the most happy, most content, and just at peace that I've ever seen him in his entire life. And this has really been a night of joy, and I think that really the function of life is joy and love. And if you'd asked me at different times, would CML be the bringer of this type of joy, I probably would not have guessed so. But I think this has just been a beautiful evening, and I think is a sign of a start of a beautiful new phase. And congratulations. It is really wonderful. Beautiful bride, beautiful family. It's a wonderful experience. L'chaim.
Hey, what are you doing?
turning on my sexy. I know you can't wait to touch me, but baby, don't do nothing. I just want you to watch me. Give you a show while my hips thrill slow. Boy, I bet I know how to screw your mind till it blows. Just don't leave without my heart. No way, no way, no way, no way, no way, no way. Don't leave without my heart. No way, no way, no way, no way. Baby, 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 give me some love. Grab your keys, I wanna finish what we're starting on the floor. Starting on the floor.
Freaky little flex, go a little low, why you go sit to let? Baby, put the gut to it, don't like me, no bitch, I play. I'm gonna make you sweat. Oh, yeah, drop it down low. And if you want to back it up, you back it up slow. Make my mind blow, let them know. Say, make them know, try come close. Cause this not private show. Yeah. And if you wanna let loose, let loose. Even if you have to take off your shoes, make you not send nobody. Cause now you got your body. Baby, oh, yeah, better see go.
swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. 'Cause I need you to